It's a very important model. Dividend discount. Here, discount, what we mean is finding out the present value. Discounting here means finding out the present value. So we need to find the present value of dividend discount model is based on the following assumption. One is the dividends are paid annually. It is a common practice. Another assumption is the first dividend is received after 1 year. That is the first assumption. So we have six different models we have under dividend discount model. One is the single period valuation model, first model, single period valuation model. So this model assumes that the equity shareholder buys equity share and holds equity share for 1 year. So he buys equity share and keeps equity share for 1 year, then we can apply this particular model, the single period valuation model. So how do we get the equity price? D1, that is the dividend per share of the current year, divide by 1 plus R. 1 plus R means your rate of return. So why are we dividing it by 1 plus R? Because we need to get the present value of the dividend, plus P1, the current market price. Current market price divide by 1 plus R. Divide by 1 plus R will give you the current value of the market price. When you add, that will give you the current theoretical price. The current theoretical price. Okay. See, for example, look at the example. The equity share of a company is expected to provide dividend of rupees 2 and fetch rupees 18 a year hence. So after 1 year, the price the equity share will be 18. The required rate of return is 12%. So what is the equity share of particular company today? So 2 divided by 1.12, that is 1 plus R, plus 18 divided by 1.12, that will give me 17.86. That is the value today. So after 1 year, the price will be what? 18. Okay. So this is how we calculate the equity share price of the theoretical price. Okay. Hope all of you understood. So dividend is given. The price after 1 year is given. So dividend divided by 1 plus R plus price after 1 year divided by 1 plus R, which will give you the market, theoretical equity share price. Okay. So the single period valuation model assumes that you buy the share and keeps the share for 1 year. Then second model is constant growth model. That means the dividend is growing at a constant rate. So for example, 5% every year, the dividend is growing. So in that scenario, how do we get the equity share price? That is D1 divided by R minus G. G is what? Growth rate. R is the rate of return. D1 is your dividend. Look at the case. Suppose that expected dividend per share of a company is 2. The dividend per share has grown over the past years 5% per year. The growth rate is expected to continue in the future. Further, the market price equity share is expected the same rate. So we want to know the fair estimate of intrinsic value of the equity share if the required rate of return is 15%. The dividend is growing at 5%. So in such case, how do we get the theoretical equity price? So 2 dividend, D divided by R minus G. So D is 2, R is 0.5, G is growth rate. So R minus G, which will give you 0.01. So 2 divided by 0.01, you will get 20 rupees. Look at another case, what is given there. Assume that you have purchased the shares of a company which is expected to grow at 6% per annum. The dividend expected on your share a year hence is rupees 2. And what price will you put on if the required rate of return is 14%? So 2, dividend is 2, divided by R is 14%, 0.14, minus it's growing at 6%, 0.06, so 0.08. So 2 divided by 0.08, you will get 25. So this is called a constant growth model. So constant growth model assumes that dividend is growing at a constant rate in the future. Okay. So different model is brought up with a lot of assumptions, because unlike the bonds, bonds have got the fixed maturity period, but here equities do not have a fixed maturity period. So how long we can calculate? See, for example, bonds we did 4-year maturity period means what we did was I divide by coupon rate divided by 1 plus r power 1 plus coupon rate divided by 1 plus r power 2. We keep on going. The last year you receive a principal payment, then you add a principal payment divided by 1 plus r power n you have done. But here we cannot do all this. So each model is brought with a lot of assumptions. Then third assumption the particular dividend discount model is zero growth model. So zero growth model assumes that there is no growth in dividend. The assumption is that dividend will be maintained at their current level forever. Okay, so the company is giving 5 rupees first year, the same 5 rupees you'll be getting till the company is closed. So in that case, how do we get the theoretical equity share price? So D divided by R, dividend divided by R. So D is the dividend, R is the rate of return. So here the previous equation is given, D0 is equal to D1, D1 is equal to D2, it goes on like that. Okay, so in that scenario, so dividend divided by R, rate of return, that will give you the equity share price. So Hindustan Manufacturing Company Limited has distributed dividend of rupees 30 on each equity share of rupees 10. The expected rate of return is 35%. Calculate the current market price by substituting the formula. So 30 is the dividend, and the equity share price is rupees 10. So 30 divided by 0.35. The expected rate of return is 0.35. So 30 divided by 0.35 is 85.71. That is your current theoretical price. Okay. Still, all of you understood till three models? We'll take up the single paid valuation model